folks, welcome back to the channel. I'm your host, Imperial Arm. Today we're going to be taking a look at Hydroneer. Hydroneer is a gold mining, building simulation game. It's got a bit of exploration in it, a bit of automation. We can build some very interesting machines and do some different things while we're trying to make a fortune around this area. So it's Steam. It's on Steam right now. I think it's on sale for the next couple of days. I think it's like $17.99. maybe $20 at launch. It's definitely an interesting little game, so let's dive right into it. If you guys haven't already done so, make sure you subscribe to the channel for more videos, updates like this. Leave a comment down in the section. Let me know what I'm doing right, what I'm doing wrong, ways to improve and stuff like that. So anyway, let's dive right into it. Yeah, we're gonna start a new game. All right, so here we are. World looks gorgeous. I mean, it's kind of that voxel World of Warcraft kind of looking graphics. So there is no inventory, so there's not like we're not going to pick these things up, put them in an inventory, and then open up the inventory later on and use. Basically what we're going to do is we're going to take our mines. We're going to need that for when it gets dark. Come over here and set it down. We interact with things in the world with the E key. Let's pick up the shovel like that, and then we mouse click to actually use said shovel and stuff like that. So starting out, we get a shovel, we get our lantern, we get a map that shows us the world, and we'll take a look at the map real quick. There's the map. All right, shows us some dig sites, shows us where we can sell stuff. Some of those other dig sites, the Middler's Aquifer and what was that, Dedrick Direct Quarry, South Hope, those are all for sale. We'd have to buy those. We got to make some money to buy those first. We have a small bucket we can put our dirt in. We have a panning bucket, and then we have a brush. So we're gonna throw a brush down over here. All right, so here's what we're gonna do. Come over here, we're gonna find. So this we cannot dig in. This is hard packed. This is nothing we can dig in. This is like the boundary of our diggable area. So we're gonna come over here. Oh, I forgot to do something. Gotta grab the other bucket. Drop our bucket there. Pick back up our shovel. Go ahead and fill that up. And that's full. Come over here, and then we're going to get this lined up. Dump our dirt in there. The one major thing that I have noticed about the game and the little bit that I had played prior to actually starting the series is that it seems like So the bucket's here. See the little green circle? That's where you can dump at. So like to get it over there, we gotta line it up. It would make more sense if that blue dot was where we actually dumped things. And maybe I'm just wrong. All right, but anyway. All right, so water's in the bucket. We picked the bucket up. Got some water in there now. Grab our brush. And we got some gold. Awesome. So we're gonna stack our gold right here for now. So we're gonna dump the bucket out. There's our gold. Drop that back down. Bring our bucket over here. Now I sent our bucket flying. Let's keep in mind the game is still in. Unless it's launched, but it's still kind of early access. There's more features being added. It's made by a one-man development studio, and for one man, this is a pretty neat little title. I mean, there's a lot of automation stuff. We'll go take a look at some of that stuff in a bit. Some of the things we can get before we run out of here. But basically, this is just going to show you how the first stages of your game go. It's going to be pretty slow going initially. There we go. What to do? You get money. You get more money. You go get the things you need to increase your production. So this time we got a gold nugget, all right, but we also got, if we can get a hold of it, we got an iron, we got an uncut emerald. So the uncut emerald, we can buy a grinding stone for later on, or later on when we have the money, and that'll give us the ability to cut those stones and make them worth more, and then we can use them to make jewelry, and jewelry's worth more, obviously, than just uncut raw resources. So but we'll look at that, get a couple more nuggets before we head over to the store and show you exactly what we can buy. There we go, in the bucket. save the iron for later. The iron can be smelted down to make weapons. Weapons sell for more, obviously, than just raw resources. And it's just cooler to make weapons than it is just to sell raw iron resources. We'll have to smelt that down, make ingots out of it, and then use an anvil and some blacksmithing hammer, stuff like that. Some of you guys might be wondering, why am I not taking the shovel and just dumping the dirt directly into the bucket just to expedite things? Well, this is what happens when you do that. Another scoop right there. We cannot do it. It only gets that one bit, which isn't typically going to yield us anything. At least when I was doing the playthroughs, it didn't yield me anything. So there we go. All right. So into the bucket we go. With more resources. Eventually you'll get used to it though, and it won't be that bad, but it's still kind of just dump it out. There we go. Still kind of weird, I guess, the way that it's set up. Like, I mean, I think it would make more sense if it were there on the actual blue marker. So, but what do I know? I'm not a game designer, so it is the way it is, and we'll adapt and overcome. Alright, so. Nope, got ahead of myself. Alright. Go. Some more iron ore, which is not what we really need right now. We really need gold. I mean, we can sell the iron ore right now if we wanted to, but it's just in the long run it's going to be more beneficial if we just hold on to it and smelt it down into weapons and stuff like that. So initially, when you're getting started on the game, it is kind of a slow progression, so be very aware of that. If you decide you're going to buy the game for yourself, it's going to take you a while, although there could be a faster way. Maybe I just don't know. I'm still too much of a noob to the game, so if anybody else has played the game and they know a better way to do this, to get into the early or get into the game a little quicker, then by all means, please let me know in the comments section. So, and I just punted my bucket. Where did it go? Oh no. Well. Oh, there we go. Come on, bucket. Dump the water out, because we don't need water in there. Alright. Although it does beg the question, can we drop the bucket in the water? Is this going to work? No, I got rid of all of our dirt. Unfortunate. Okay, you can't do that. Don't make that mistake. All right. There is a bed if we want to skip nighttime, although we don't have the resources right now for the beds, so we're not going to be able to skip nighttime. So what we'll do is we'll just mine through the night until we get enough money to buy some resources for what we need. Base building in the game, so you can like build a little mining base or whatever you want to, and then I've seen some people who are also doing videos on the game. They've got some pretty ingenious setups and automations and contraptions and buildings, you know, things that facilitate quicker gathering of resources and whatnot. So definitely a lot to do with the game. There's a goal. we're gonna bring this over here. It's gonna start getting. Alright, we're gonna set that down there. We're just gonna let it go. And you're digging along here. Take a look at the stores real quick and see what we can buy. I have an ideal from my earlier playthrough when I was testing the game out to make sure everything was running correctly and okay. I have an ideal on how to maybe make this a little bit faster, hopefully. Oh, get in there. Get a bucket. Take our bucket, we're gonna go over here. We're gonna sell right over here. There is some more areas. There's some stuff up there we can go buy if we wanted to and check out. And then that's ours, by the way. So that's our hydro truck. It runs off of water. Actually, I lied. We gotta go up there anyway, because that's where we sell our gold for right now. All right. So truck's a little fiddly. I don't like messing with it too much. I mean, it's okay, but like, I'm still trying to learn how to play the game. So, alright, so 76 out of all of, let's jump up here and look at this real quick. So all that gold right there equals 76 coin. Alright, so put our coin in there. We're gonna run back down the hill here. We're gonna rinse and repeat this whole cycle over and over again. So I'm going to leave all of this unedited, like the first 30 minutes of the game, just so you guys know what you're getting into. Let's see, what can we buy with 76? Put our money in there. An intake. How much are these? 22. So let's see here. Let's do this. This is 58. What if we do one more? That's 80. And we got how much? 76. Okay. So we're going to have to wait for that. Oh. That would have been catastrophic. We'd have never found that again. Alright, so let's go up here. Looks like we're doing some more hand jamming on the, resources. Actually, I think we can buy a bed. Let's go see if we can buy a bed. That'll be our first investment that we take with our hard-earned money. Yeah, we can buy a bed. So let's drop our cash in there. It's going to cost us 43. And we're going to start launching things left and right. Not you, not you. Alright, so the bed's ours. So you just right or left click on the bed, it brings us up to daylight now. Let's go grab our money real quick. Hopefully that didn't disappear, despawn on us. Nope, still there. Alright, so we got 33. So I'm thinking we're probably gonna need about roughly 100-ish, 150-ish gold to do exactly what I want to do. And what I basically want to do is I want to put an intake valve and then pipes coming over here to where this slopes down. Maybe right here would be a good area, and then put our bucket, our panning bucket over there, so we can just dump dirt in there, brush it off, and then collect the resources and go on about that. So let's see. The further you dig down, the better the resources get, supposedly. I don't know. I haven't dug that far down yet, so I don't know. But we will find out. Does that work? Oh, it does work. Okay, cool. All right. Let's move our bucket over here a little bit. Get some resources. Now, we'll leave it there. We'll leave it alone for a second. Actually, no, it's getting annoying. There we go. Alright, so more iron ore. Maybe we sell the iron ore to make up the difference in the money that we need. But this is interesting, though. So, this is a shard. This powers different things in the world. So there are some water pressure pumps to increase the water pressure on your when you get to your automation stage, and that's how you power them, is through that. And then there's some other equipable items that use shards as well. So I don't know if shards are sellable, and I don't know if we're at the point right now that we can actually use shards, so it might be worth us trying to sell those. Do a couple more bucketfuls. We'll the hole there. And I went somewhere over there. We'll go get it here in a few minutes. So again, the game is still in development. By a one-man studio, so it is what it is. There are bound to be things that are gonna happen. And honestly, if our stuff getting punted across the world, as long as we can find it, is the least of our concerns, then we're okay. Oh, there it is right there. All right. Turn it off for the time being. We're gonna set it here next to our little camp, so we're not gonna need it, because we're just gonna sleep through the cycles now. Okay. All right. A little bit more here. Dirt on that one. Alright, so I think with that right there, we're gonna head back to the shop. We're gonna load everything up to include the uncut diamond or the uncut gem. I'm sure we'll be able to get more of those once we actually get things rolling along. So we're gonna get all this gathered up. We're gonna gather this up. Take the shard, because I don't know if we can use it right now. Everything in the bucket. Alright, and then we're gonna take our bucket, we're gonna run back up the hill here, and we're gonna go up to the castle and sell all this stuff off, see if we can get some stuff to kind of move things along. So plus what we got, we might be okay with that. Alright, so there's that. Okay, it does not look like we can get rid of the shards, so drop our money. I'm trying to drop our money together. up here and take a look, see what's up here in the castle real quick. So, all right. So here we can, so this will show us the price. So rings are up 53. So I don't know exactly what we'd get, but we would get something if we sell it. I think it's based on weights and gems and stuff like that. So I hadn't gotten to that stage yet. I just figured we'd jump in, play the game. You guys could see it as we go along here. So not a whole lot else up here. Nice little statue of a warrior holding a sword. I think that's made of gold. So clearly people are doing well for themselves mining around here. Nothing here. So let's go down and see what we can purchase. Actually, you know what? We'll wait on purchasing anything for right now. What I want to do real quick is I want to show you guys the other areas real quick. So we'll get in the truck with Q. Like you would expect it to, although it's, like I said, it's kind of fiddly. And then this bridge is super sketchy. Like, there's no rails. Like, I don't know what happens if I fall off this thing. I know there is an unstuck feature. You can just tell it to unstick yourself. So here's another little town. This is where we can sell. This is another one of the auctions or markets. So here rings are worth 50, so we'd be better off selling rings back there and necklaces here. So it's got a bit of trading economic to it as well, so it's definitely worth a check out if you guys are interested in it. Again, there'll be a link to the Steam page down in the description of the video. So also real quick, while I was thinking about it, guys, you see right there below the video, in the black box portion of the video, is my streamer links, right? So instead of bombarding you guys with a bunch of different icons and whatnot, you know, for social medias, you guys can go to that one link right there. It's got a QR code as well, and that'll take you to all my social media. So my Twitter, my Twitch, which I stream over on Twitch, almost every day of the week right now, except for the weekends, really. Every Monday through Friday. But Twitter's the best way to figure out when and what I'm streaming. Also, Instagram, all the other good social media links, all in one convenient little package right there for you, so you guys don't gotta go remembering 100 different things. So, all right. So, here we are. Housing, so we can make houses. There's a bunch of stuff here to make. Fishing pots, because you can fish in the game. Tool racks, construction hammers, fishing poles, roofs, stairs, you know, everything you would need to make a house or a building, right? Looks like that doesn't do anything. Got a little graveyard over here. Little dragon skull house. That's cool. So here's vehicles. So this is what we currently have right now. We have a hydro truck. We can get this thing. This thing just chews up land, puts all the dirt back here, and then I'm assuming you have to pump water into it and filter out your materials, although I can't get up to see how it exactly works. So, all right. So another jeweler here if we wanted to sell stuff right here. If we were on our way down here, this would be where we'd go. So in here, tons of stuff. Goliath drills, all kinds of different drills do different things. Funnels, here's the water pressure gauge. Here's the water pressure tank, which is why you need the shards. Different tools to fix the stuff, intakes. Again, scales, grinding stones, what we use to cut down gems. Saws for clean cutting metal bars, so if we wanted to break down metal bars to smaller things. Improved shovels and whatnot. Mining helmets so that we don't have to have a lamp no more. Conveyor shredders, all kinds of stuff. So you can get a lot of automation stuff going on here. So over here is the furnishings. So once once you actually get a house built or you start rolling in money, you can decorate your house, safes. Golden statue heads so that you can put display your different jewelries, a throne, all right, all kinds of stuff. Fancy bed, carpets, rugs, stuff like that. All right, so, and then scrapyard. So anything that say we build an automation and we end up upgrading it later on, or we get a better site, or we don't need those resources no more. We bring them over here, we can scrap them out, we'll get some cash back. My understanding is I haven't used it yet though, so I don't know 100%. But while we're here, that wants to keep popping through. All right, so let's get this loaded up real quick. Let's grab our other stuff. Do it all in one shot instead of having to run back and forth and grab every little thing. So, all right, there we go. So, we got all of our stuff now. We'll jump in our truck. I'm gonna try to turn around right here. We'll see how this actually works out, if we can actually do it or not. Buy this when we come over here, we put money in there, but it doesn't say how much it's for. Whew. That's a lot of money right now that we don't have. So, my pipes in here, I'm missing a pipe. No, they're all there. Okay, all right. Make sure again, if you're not subscribed, to subscribe, follow for more content. there will be a link in the description to get it on Steam if you want to play it for yourself. And anyway, guys, until next time, as always, thank you and have fun.